Welcome back. For our final segment, the second part in our series, How an MRE is Born. In the first segment, we checked out how recipes for the new food items are designed in the military's test kitchen. But that's only part of the process. Each snack and entree must be rigorously tested to make sure it delivers the calories and nutrition needed to keep troops fighting. Military Times' Sarah Sicard looks at the science behind how MREs are tested for performance.
Welcome back to Military Times' look at how an MRE is born. Last time, we saw the test kitchen where MRE meal items are designed and cooked up, but there's a lot more to the process than just the dishes. There's a ton of science behind making sure MREs can keep active troops sustained and fighting in the field. An entire Army research division in Natick, Massachusetts is dedicated to studying how MREs sustain our troops. In this week's segment, we look at MRE nutrition and the great lengths scientists go to ensure soldiers get the most from their meals. We talked to Dr. James McClung, a nutritional biochemist with the Army, about how the service studies MREs for effectiveness. Hi, Dr. McClung. Thanks for joining us. If you wouldn't mind, could you just sort of, you know, introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about what you do?
Hi, Sarah. So as you indicate, I'm James McClung. I'm the chief of the Military Nutrition Division at the Army Research Institute of Environmental Medicine. The mission of our team is to understand warfighter nutritional requirements and to pass that information along to the Combat Feeding Division that then does the research and development for combat rations.
What does a nutritional biochemist really do for the average soldier?
My background is in nutritional biochemistry, and so I've got this fascination with the way that the nutrients work, particularly how do the nutrients work for our military personnel and how may that be similar to or different from civilian populations. As far as ration design goes, our group is at the very front end of that.
In terms of, I guess, MRE development, walk me through that process. Does it start with sort of a conceptualization of the nutrition first, or do you start with, you know, say, let's say one of the more recent MREs to come out is the pepperoni pizza. Was that something that, you know, it started out as an idea of, you know, we want to develop pepperoni pizza, or was it more of, you know, we need to get these nutrients into this form, and then you reverse engineer it that way?
So we're on the front end of that process. Our role is to understand what the nutritional requirements are. So basically, we gather evidence and information. Once we do that, we hand it off to our partners at the Combat Feeding Division, who then make a product that meets those nutritional requirements while also having the appeal and shelf stability requirements of a ration item for our warfighters. So it all begins with the knowledge regarding the nutrients that should be in a food product, and then transitions into the development of that material product that you might see out in the field.
Walk me through how you test an MRE for its nutritional value. What are some of the tests that you carry out in order to sort of find out, you know, I guess whether it's somebody who's going to be under the ocean in a submarine or somebody who's out in, you know, the desert for, you know, days or weeks at a time. How do you sort of test, you know, what's going into their food so that they can, you know, perform in an optimal manner?
Right. So these are very involved biochemical processes by which a food item, a ration item, would be taken and then chemically analyzed for each vitamin, mineral, and macronutrient to include carbohydrate, protein, and fat. The methods for each of those nutrients is slightly different in the laboratory. A ration item would be burned in a flame that is very specific. When that ration item is burned, it will elude a certain wavelength of light, which we can detect for the analysis of minerals. Here in the Military Nutrition Division in our applied laboratory, we will oftentimes assess the metabolism of nutrients using human volunteers. To do so, we may provide them with a prototype food product, which has nutrients that are labeled using stable isotopes. We may then ask them to engage in a relevant activity, such as patrolling. We will ask them to wear body armor while donning the uniform and marching on a treadmill, while also consuming the food product, at which point we may be able to draw blood or other biological specimens in real time to track the metabolism of such nutrients and their impact on military performance.
And that's all we have time for this week. Please visit us on militarytimes.com and defensenews.com for more coverage. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next week.